Okay, hello cloud gurus. How y'all doing? I'm Scott Pletcher back with another set of news that you just cannot refuse. This week, the Well-Architected Framework gets some new expansion packs. I give some love to a humble but important AWS service and learn how you can start building video games for free. That's right, all right here on AWS This Week. Ever since I watched Matthew Broderick plug up his acoustic coupler and hook into Whopper in the 1983 movie War Games, I have been fascinated with online gaming. And for those of you who have been around for a while, you might recall the original bulletin board systems of the 80s and early 90s. And some of those associated BBS games like Trade Wars or Motu. Well, how far we have come, or maybe we've just come full circle. There are gaming services today like NVIDIA's GeForce Now and Google's Stadia, which are fully cloud-based, allowing us to run graphics-intensive games with minimal local hardware, just as long as we have a decent internet connection, much more than the 1200 baud I enjoyed back in my BBS days. And I may or may not have tried to load Steam on AppStream. Stick around and I'll let you know how you can get a new free-to-play MMO game recently released by Amazon Game Studios. The Well-Architected Framework is a super useful tool for anyone trying to architect a cloud-based workload. It provides a structured and consistent way to walk through many important aspects of good design. As flexible as the framework is, some workloads require more domain-specific designs and best practices. AWS accommodates these specialized areas through something known as lenses. You can think of them as kind of like an expansion pack that plug into the base framework. Lenses exist for serverless workloads, high-performance computing, IoT, and financial services. This month, AWS added two new lenses to the collection, machine learning and analytics. These new additions aim to provide specific best practices in and around those respective domains and hopefully create better architectures. Exciting news this week, wait for it. AWS announced that the latest SOC 1, SOC 2, and SOC 3 reports are now available online. Well, okay, maybe that's not so exciting, but it does give me an excuse to segue into another bit of news and talk about a little known service that really should get more respect, and that's AWS Artifact, which got a new UI this week. What is Artifact? Well, Artifact is one of those services that you probably would never know about unless you had a reason to know about it, and now you do. It is a repository of all sorts of security and compliance documents like AWS's ISO certification, PCI or payment card industry compliance audits, and service organization control or SOC reports. Why Artifact? Well, AWS recognizes that an important part of cloud adoption is to make sure that all those internal and external auditors of customers are kept happy and satisfied. And these certifications and reports are usually compiled by third parties and ensure that AWS is taking the proper measures to protect data and maintain reliability in line with industry, regulatory, and international standards. Why doesn't AWS just post all these reports publicly? Are they trying to hide something? Well, no. Many of these audit reports are considered confidential and often need to be protected by a non-disclosure agreement between your company and AWS. As a result, each document is generated specifically for you and associated with your account. This generated document contains a unique watermark providing traceability directly back to AWS. And this, from an audit perspective, is a very good thing. Have you ever wanted to try your hand at video game development? Maybe you can use your quarantine quiet time to become the next Tencent or Electronic Arts. Amazon Lumberyard is a free, high-performance, real-time 3D design suite that you can use to create immersive virtual worlds, games, and simulations. It has ready-made integrations with Twitch and many AWS services to power your games. This month, AWS released Lumberyard Beta 1.24, which brings support for Visual Studio 2019, as well as a slew of bug fixes and some new improved gems, which are plugins that provide additional features. If you need some inspiration or maybe just a distraction, Amazon Game Studios recently released a free-to-play game called Crucible that was built using Lumberyard and makes use of Amazon GameLift, Kinesis, S3, Lambda, and even uses Amazon Polly, which provides the voices for some characters. You can grab it at the link down below or over on the Steam platform. It's only available for Windows, but I did get it to work using Steam Play on Ubuntu 20.04. And now on to the Guru of the Week. Well done this week, gurus, as you came up with 40 responses to our question with many, many creative answers. It was a hard decision, but alas, there can be only one Guru of the Week, and that person is Ankit Patel, a systems engineer from Baltimore, Maryland in the US. A glorious swag pack is on its way to you, and presuming that reInvent will still be held this year, you've also been entered into a draw for a ticket to said event. If you think your Guru of the Week material, have a look at our question this week in the links down below. That, my friends, is all the AWS news that is fit to print this week. Until next time, go play some games and keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus.